We've all have experienced moments of deja vu, but what if this sensation actually has a scientific basis? Let's dive into the amazing theories that help us understand time. Hey there, time travelers and future enthusiasts. Have you ever had that weird feeling where you're absolutely certain you've experienced something before, even though you know it's happening for the first time? Or maybe you've dreamt about an event that later came true? Well, I hope you got your helmet on, because we're about to dive headfirst into the mind-bending world of time and physics, where the future might have already happened. Let's start with a brain twister. What if I told you that the now you're experiencing right this second isn't the same now for someone on the other side of the planet, or even for your neighbor next door? Sounds crazy, right? But according to Einstein's theory of relativity, that might exactly be how our universe works. Time isn't this fixed, universal thing that ticks away at the same rate for everyone. It's more like a stretchy, bendy fabric that can't be wrapped and twisted. Imagine you're on a cosmic trampoline, and every massive object in the universe is like a bowling ball sitting on it. The heavier the object, the more it stretches the fabric of space-time. This is why time actually passes more slowly near massive objects like black holes. If you could somehow survive near a black hole, you might experience only a few minutes while years pass by on Earth. But it's not just gravity that messes with time. Speed does too. Let's say you're on a super-fast spaceship zooming through the cosmos at nearly the speed of light. While you're busy playing intergalactic ping pong, time for you would slow down compared to your friends back on Earth. You might return from your space vacation only a year older, but find that decades have passed on your home planet. Talk about jet lag. This weird time dilation effect isn't just some far-out theory. We can measure it right here on Earth. GPS satellites, which orbit at high speeds, experience time slightly different than we do on the ground. If we didn't account for this time difference, your GPS would be off by about 10 kilometers a day. So, the next time you use your phone to navigate to the nearest pizza joint, thank Einstein for making sure you don't end up in the middle of nowhere. Now, let's get really wild and talk about the block universe theory. Imagine the entire history of the universe, past, present, and future, as one giant cosmic loaf of bread. Each slice represents a moment in time. According to this theory, all these slices exist simultaneously. The future is already there, baked into the cosmic loaf. We just haven't reached that slice yet. If this is true, then in a sense, the future has already happened. It's like a movie reel that's all there, but we're only seeing it frame by frame. This idea messes with our notion of free will and makes us question if our choices really matter. But don't freak out just yet. Remember, this is just one interpretation of how time might work. Speaking of interpretations, let's talk about how we perceive time. Our brains are constantly playing tricks on us when it comes to time. Ever notice how time seems to slow down when you're bored but flies when you're having fun? Or how about those moments of danger when everything seems to move in slow motion? This subjective experience of time is all thanks to our brain's timekeeping mechanisms. When we're in high-stress situations, our brain goes into overdrive, processing more information per second than usual. This makes us feel like time is stretching out, even though objectively it's ticking away at the same rate. But here's where it gets really trippy. Some scientists argue that our perception of time flowing from past to future is just an illusion created by our brains to make sense of the world. In reality, they say there might not be any fundamental difference between past, present, and future. It's all just there. This brings us to a mind-bending question. If the future already exists in some form, can we ever truly change it? Are our choices predetermined, or do we have the power to shape our destiny? These questions have puzzled philosophers and scientists for centuries, and they tie directly into debates about free will and determinism. Some argue that if the future is already set, then free will is just an illusion. Others say that even in a block universe, our choices still matter because they're part of what shapes that predetermined future. It's like being an actor in a play. The script might be written, but your performance still matters. But wait, there's more. What if instead of a single predetermined future, there are multiple possible futures? This idea ties into quantum mechanics, which suggests that at the tiniest scales, the universe is inherently probabilistic. Maybe the future isn't a single slice of the cosmic bread loaf, but more like a bunch of tangled spaghetti strands, each representing a different possible outcome. This multiverse idea isn't just science fiction. It's a serious scientific theory that attempts to explain some of the weirdest aspects of quantum mechanics. According to this view, every time a quantum event could have multiple outcomes, the universe splits into parallel realities, where each outcome occurs. So in a sense, all possible futures are happening. We only just experience one of them. If your head is spinning right now, don't worry, you're in good company. Even the most brilliant physicists grapple with these mind-bending concepts. The nature of time remains one of the biggest mysteries in science, sitting at the intersection of physics, philosophy, and human experience. If you thought relativity was mind-bending, quantum physics is like taking your brain, tying it in a pretzel, and then dunking it in a vat of cosmic uncertainty. Let's start with the basics. In the quantum realm, things get fuzzy. And I don't mean in a cute, cuddly kitten way. I mean in a what-even-is-reality-anymore kind of way. At the tiniest scales, particles don't behave like the solid, predictable objects we're used to. Instead, they act more like waves of probability. Imagine you're trying to catch a mischievous quantum particle. You set up detectors all around, but here's where things get shaken up. Until you actually observe it, that particle exists in all possible locations at once. It's everywhere and nowhere, like a teenager's dirty socks. This is called superposition. And it's the quantum equivalent of having your cake and eating it too. But wait, it gets even weirder. Let's talk about quantum entanglement, the spooky action at a distance that even Einstein found too bizarre to swallow. Picture two particles that are entangled. They're like the quantum world's version of twins separated at birth. No matter how far apart you separate these particles, if you measure one, you instantly know the state of the other. It's like they're cosmically connected by some invisible quantum hotline. This entanglement messes with our ideas of cause and effect. In the classical world, if I poke you and you say, ouch, there's a clear sequence of events. But in the quantum world, it's like you could say, ouch, before I even decide to poke you. It's as if the future is reaching back to influence the past, creating a cosmic chicken and egg scenario that would make any philosopher's head spin. Now, let's dive into the many worlds interpretation, which is basically the quantum physics version of choose your own adventure. According to this theory, every time a quantum event could have multiple outcomes, the universe splits into parallel realities where each outcome occurs. So, in one universe, you decided to watch this video, while in another, you're off wrestling alligators or learning to yodel. What do you think is the most accurate theory about how time works? Let us know in the comments below. Going back, this means that every decision you've ever made, from what to have for breakfast to whether to ask out your crush, has created a branching timeline. There could be infinite versions of you out there, living out every possible variation of your life. Maybe in one of those universes, you're a famous rock star. Or maybe you're a sentient potato. These possibilities are literally endless. But if all these possibilities exist, why do we only experience one reality? This is where things get really trippy. Some physicists suggest that our consciousness somehow chooses which reality to experience. Imagine your mind riding the waves of probability, picking what version of reality becomes your truth. This idea has led some to speculate about quantum immortality, which is to think if there are infinite universes, then, in at least one of them, you always survive any potential fatal event. And since you can only experience the universes where you're alive, from your perspective, you might never die. It's a comforting thought, but I wouldn't recommend testing it by juggling chainsaws or anything. Now, let's talk about quantum tunneling, which is nature's way of saying rules are made to be broken. In the classical world, if you throw a ball at a wall, it bounces back. But in the quantum world, there's a tiny chance that the particle could just pass right through the wall. It's like the particle decided the laws of physics were more like guidelines and just noped right through a solid barrier. This isn't just some theoretical quirk. Quantum tunneling is crucial for nuclear fusion in stars and even plays a role in DNA mutations. It's also the basis for scanning tunneling microscopes, which let us see individual atoms. Let's take a moment to appreciate how utterly bizarre all of this is. In the quantum world, particles can be in multiple places at once, instantly communicate across vast distances, and even pop in and out of existence. It's like the universe, at its most fundamental level, is a cosmic magic show, complete with disappearing acts and impossible feats. Here's what stands out. All of this quantum weirdness underlies the seemingly solid and predictable world we experience every day. Your body, this planet, even your morning coffee, it's all made up of these quirky quantum particles doing their probabilistic dance. So how does this all relate to the future? Well, if the quantum world is inherently probabilistic, with multiple possible outcomes for every event, then the future isn't set in stone. Instead, it's more like a shimmering sea of possibilities, with each wave representing a potential future. This quantum uncertainty challenges the idea of a single predetermined future. Instead, it suggests a multiverse of potential futures, all existing in a state of superposition until we observe or interact with them. Some physicists have even proposed that we might be able to quantum leap between these different potential futures. Imagine being able to jump to a timeline where you made a different choice, or where events played out differently. It's not quite time travel, but it's the next best thing. But before you get too excited about quantum leaping to a reality where you're a billionaire superhero, remember that we're still talking about effects at the quantum scale. Translating these tiny quantum fluctuations into large-scale changes in the macroscopic world is, well, let's just say it's complicated. Still, the implications of quantum mechanics for our understanding of the future are profound. If the future exists as a probability wave of possible outcomes, then, in a sense, all potential futures are equally real until we collapse the wave function by making an observation or choice. This brings us back to the question, did the future really happen? In the quantum world, the answer might be yes, no, and maybe all at once. The future, like Schrödinger's infamous cat, exists in a superposition of states. All potential futures simultaneously exist until we open the box by living it. Now, let's dive into the really juicy stuff, the mind-bending implications of all this temporal tomfoolery, and what it means for our understanding of the future. First up, let's talk about the arrow of time. You might think time always flows in one direction, like a river heading towards the ocean of the future. But get this, most laws of physics work just fine whether time runs forwards or backwards. So why do we experience time as a one-way street? Enter entropy, which is basically a measure of disordered states. And according to the second law of thermodynamics, it always increases over time. This is why your room doesn't spontaneously clean itself, much to the disappointment of teenagers everywhere, and why you can't unscramble an egg. This relentless march towards disorder gives time its apparent direction. It's like the universe is playing a cosmic game of Jenga, and we're all just watching the tower get wobblier and wobblier. But here's a wild thought. What if somewhere out there in the multiverse, there's a universe where entropy decreases and time runs backwards? Imagine a world where you start your life as an old person and gradually get younger. You'd remember the future and have no idea about the past. Talk about a mind-bender. Now, let's really get wild and talk about time travel. Thanks to Einstein, we know that time travel to the future is totally possible. Just go really fast or hang out near a black hole. But traveling to the past, that's where things get tricky. Some physicists have proposed the idea of closed time-like curves, which are basically paths through space-time that loop back on themselves. If you could follow one of these curves, you'd end up back where, or should I say when, you started. It's like the universe's version of a roundabout, but instead of just going in circles, you're circling through time itself. But time travel comes with a host of paradoxes that would make even the most seasoned sci-fi writer's head spin. There's the classic grandfather paradox. What if you went back in time and prevented your grandparents from meeting? Would you cease to exist? Or would the universe create a new timeline branching off from the moment of your interference? Some physicists argue that the universe has a built-in chronology protection mechanism that prevents such paradoxes from occurring. It's like the universe has its own temporal bouncer, keeping would-be time travelers in line. But others suggest that paradoxes could be resolved through the many-worlds interpretation we talked about earlier. In this view, if you went back and changed the past, you'd simply be creating or jumping to a new parallel universe, leaving your original timeline intact. But let's step back from these wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey ideas for a moment and consider a more fundamental question. Is the future a concrete reality waiting to happen, or is it a sea of possibilities that only solidifies when we reach it? This brings us to the age-old debate of determinism versus free will. If the future is set in stone, predetermined by the initial conditions of the universe and the laws of physics, then do our choices really matter? Are we just actors playing out a cosmic script, or do we have the power to shape our destiny? Quantum mechanics throws a wrench into the deterministic worldview by introducing fundamental uncertainty at the smallest scales. But does this uncertainty translate to free will at the human scale? Some argue that quantum effects are too small to influence our decision-making processes, while others suggest that the brain might amplify these tiny quantum fluctuations, resulting in truly unpredictable choices. Then there's the block universe theory we mentioned earlier, which suggests that past, present, and future all exist simultaneously in a four-dimensional block of space-time. In this view, the future is just as real and fixed as the past. We just haven't experienced it yet. But even in a block universe, our choices could still matter. Think of it like this. The future pages of the book might be written, but your choices are what's writing them. You're simultaneously the author and the reader of your life story, crafting the future even as you experience it. This leads us to a fascinating possibility. What if our perception of making choices in the present is actually shaping the future retroactively? It's like Schrödinger's cat, but instead of a cat in a box, it's your entire future life, existing in a superposition of states until you collapse the wave function by living it. Some physicists have even proposed more radical ideas like retrocausality, the notion that future events can influence the past. Imagine a universe where cause and effect are more like a cosmic dance than a linear progression. Your future self might be reaching back through time, subtly influencing your present decisions. It's like getting life advice from your future self, but instead of a phone call, it's through quantum entanglement. All of this leaves us with a profound question. If the future, in some sense, already exists, can we ever truly change it? Or are we just playing out a predetermined script with the illusion of free will? Perhaps the answer lies in embracing uncertainty. Maybe the future isn't a fixed destination or even a set of probable outcomes, but a dynamic, ever-evolving landscape shaped by the interplay of quantum probabilities, cosmic forces, and our own choices. In this view, every decision we make, every action we take, is like casting a stone into a pond of space-time, sending ripples through the fabric of reality. We might not be able to predict exactly how these ripples will interact and what future they'll create, but we can choose how to cast our stones. So, did the future really happen? Well, in a way, it's happening right now, with every choice you make and every quantum particle that decides to zig instead of zag. The future is a collaborative effort between you and the universe, a cosmic improvisation where the script is being written even as it's performed. And that, dear viewers, is both terrifying and incredibly liberating. It means that while we can't control everything about our future, we do have a say in shaping it. Every choice, every action, every quantum decision is a brushstroke on the canvas of tomorrow. We may not know the future and what it's made of, but I know one thing for sure. I had a blast making today's episode. Would you like us to cover the next episode on what is the best decade to time travel? Let us know in the comments below, and as always, stay insanely curious.